Live animals have been transported by air since the early 30s. Airlines play an important role carrying the animals, offering the most human and expedient methods of transportation over long distances, whether it is a pet, an animal transported for zoological or agricultural purposes, conservation, or for any other reason. The most commonly transported animals by all airlines remain cats, dogs, lobsters and crabs, day-old chicks, horses, and some zoo animals such as leopards, cheetahs, etc. Just keep in mind that some dogs, the ones with short noses, such as the bulldogs, cannot really be transported by air due to issues involved with their breathing. Adult giraffes cannot fly, as we can't feed the tallest animal in an aircraft fuselage. Ensuring animal safety and welfare during transport is the main objective of the international standards and regulations described in the IATA Live Animal Regulations, the LAR. It is expected that every company involved in the handling and transport of live animals comply with the LAR to further reduce animal stress, injury, or death during transport. Continuous improvement programs, investments in enhanced facilities, and staff training are underway and need to be adopted broadly by all transport specialists involved in the handling and transport of live animals. Many air freight specialists handling and transporting animals are also involved in conservation initiatives, offering highly specialized transport expertise and dedicated chartered flights. The air cargo industry is committed to combat illegal wildlife trade and protect endangered species. Wildlife trafficking is the illegal movement of wildlife and wildlife parts or products across borders. Estimated to be worth between 7 to 23 billion a year, according to Roots, wildlife trafficking has become one of the most prominent forms of international crime globally. Transportation is the backbone of global trade, and traffickers of wild animals and wildlife products rely heavily on the efficiency of air travel and cargo carriers to smuggle illicit goods. Companies from the transportation and logistics sector can therefore play a critical role in identifying and strengthening key risk points in the supply chain. Freight forwarders, ground handlers, airports, airlines, trucking companies can build defenses against and disrupt the illegal wildlife trade with appropriate training for staff to detect smuggling attempts and assess which flight paths are most frequently used by wildlife criminals. Air cargo stakeholders can sign the Buckingham Palace Declaration and join the USAID partnerships, routes, to further develop their awareness and capabilities in that area.